Thank you, professors. And now session number 14, titled "Why: Answering the 20th Century Medical Miracle." I would like to invite the chairpersons to the stage, Professor Ashraf Atiya, Professor Fahmi Amara, Professor Mabahid Suka, Professor Mamdouh Nahas, Professor Mohammed El Bahrawi, Professor Sana Ghazali. Session number 14.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. نبدا الجلسه وفي البدايه انا سعيد وشرفت جدا ان اكون شايف سيشن مع مجموعه من الزملاء والاصدقاء ونشكر الاستاذه ايناس وزملائها وزمي المؤتمر على دعوتنا. في البدايه يسعدني ان اقدم زميلي وصديق العمر استاذ الدكتور علي عباسي استاذ الاندوكرينولوجي في جامعة اسكندرية. هيكلمنا على why insulin is needed in patients with type 2 diabetes.
Thank you very much. في البداية أشكر الأستاذ الدكتور إيناس شنتون والأستاذ الدكتور رأفت رشوان فور دعوته لي للاشتراك في هذا المؤتمر العظيم اللي احنا بنختاره كل سنة ونبقى سعداء بحضورنا. Why insulin is needed in patients with type 2 diabetes? My presentation will include the following. The type 2 diabetes is a progressive, has a progressive nature, including beta cell dysfunction and insulin resistance, leading to impaired glucose tolerance and then type 2 diabetes. We have a multi-complex pathophysiologic abnormalities type 2 diabetes, including all of these. Starting from pancreatic insulin secretion reduction, decreased incretin effect, liver increased hepatic glucose production, and the kidney decreased the renal glucose secretion, and the muscle decreased the peripheral glucose uptake. These are the main factors leading to hyperglycemia. And the treatment of type 2 diabetes targets all of these. But one of the pathophysiologic abnormalities we usually target the treatment starting with one and increasing to two and three and even more than three treatments of type 2 diabetes, the drugs of type 2 diabetes. As you know, all of these, including many that you have heard about from our speakers. The AASD and the ADA and the AASD position statement, the anti-hyperglycemic drugs of type 2 diabetes, starting with initial anti-hyperglycemic monotherapy with metformin, and we have heard a lot about metformin. من الدكتور علاء الوقت يعني شفعنا metformin من أوله لأخره خلال 60 سنة العدد اللي أمريكا ما ضربتش بالمفتوح بالمتفورمين من 57 ل 95 95 بدأت تعترف بأمريكا وحطها اللي هو الفيرست or initial monotherapy. After approximately 3 months, we proceed to second drug combination if needed to reach the individualized A1C target. So, two drug combination, and these two drugs is not restricted to one or two drugs, but many drugs, as you know. We heard about all of them, including the sulfonylurea, thiopropes, TZDs, DDP4 inhibitors, SGLT inhibitors, GLP-1 receptor analog, and lastly, insulin. All of these could lead to reduction of blood glucose in hyperglycemic type 2 diabetic patients. But we have to start by this monotherapy, which is the metformin, and we will see for 3 months. Why 3 months? Why? Because the A1C, our target vitamin chain, no salt. When the A1C will dry about 3 months, مش بعد يوم ولا اثنين. عشان كده بنستنى 3 أشهر ونشوف A1C نزل ولا لا. If not reached to the target, we proceed to next step if hemoglobin A1C not achieved after 3 months. And then triple third, if after 3 months, another 3 months, the patient did not pass to the required A1C level, we have passed to third, we have our anti-metformin with second drug lecanemab, including all of these lecanemab. وممكن يختار الحاجات اللي احنا ما استعملناهاش في التربل ثيرابي as a one. Then if these are not effective, then we proceed to the combination injectable therapy. ايه injectable therapy اللي احنا عارفينها؟ In addition to metformin, we give basal insulin, mealtime insulin, or glucagon like the type 1 receptor analog. Clinical recommendations for use of basal insulin in type 2 diabetes. According to ACE, American College of Endocrinology, and American Association of Clinical Endocrinologists, and ADA and AASD recommendation, the entry, the treatment is A1C more than 9, and the symptomatic. And then we pass to dual therapy and triple therapy as I have just mentioned. Insulin optimization or intensification, when, why, and how. Let us start when. When we think about insulin therapy, if the A1C not at the target, and in that case, why we start insulin? If the fasting blood glucose not at the target, we pass to basal insulin titration, up titration. If the A1C, the fasting blood glucose at target, but the positive angle blood glucose is not at the target, we pass to intensification and differential insulin or GLP-1 receptor analog. On the other hand, when the A1C at the target, when we start insulin, if the A1C is at the target, but free from the hypoglycemia, we pass to basal insulin, double titration or switch therapy. Basal insulin therapy advantage, once daily injection, one glucose target, which is a fasting plasma glucose, or A1C, and A1C, easy dose titration. According to the fasting plasma glucose, low dose initiation, and a small weight gain, and infrequent hypoglycemia, and there is a limited education to the patient, how to use the pen, you can educate the patient immediately in front of you. And good patient acceptability so long as the injection is once per day. So the role of basal insulin is the control of fasting blood plasma glucose and hemoglobin A1C. Action profile of newer basal insulin, including glargine 120, Dimer, Degludec 100 units and 200 units, and Glargine 300 units. Look at this. Usually, in the past, only we have NPH insulin. And عيبه بيشتغل 12 ساعة. So he gives the patient 2 to 3 times a day, any time of the day. But we pass to insulin, DTMR or insulin glargine, up to 24 hour duration action. And also, it is used once or twice a day. لا أنسى عيل صغير سنه 15 سنة كان مش مظبوط على اللاكتوس وال بري بتاع بري ميل انجكشن اوف اوفر اوف رابيد اكتنج انسولين. جاء لي لا انا لقيت حاجه كويسه قوي ان انا لو خدت 2 انجكشن من اللاكتوس في الدي مع العلاج ده كان ظبط قوي. هو اللي جاي لي كده انا ما كنتش قريتها لسه. فمعنى كده ان ممكن تديني 5 دي. اخر واحد انسولين ديجلوليت. انسولين ديجلوليت بيقولوا ان هو بيشتغل اب تو 42 اورز ديوريشن. How to initiate and titrate basal insulin. Usually there are two researchers. The first at سنة 2003 قال ندي 10 يونتس اوف انسولين تو ستارت انيشال دوز. جابانين قال لك ندي 10 يونت بينهم مع التنسيين التايتريشن الاولاني بيقول نزود 2 يونت لحد 8 يونت افري ويك. الثالث الاخر الاخر بيقول 2 يونت افري 3 دايز. To start with, لو كان fasting blood glucose أكثر من 200 أكثر من 200 بيتزود 4 units. لو 125 to 200 بيدي 2 units. لو 72 to 126 ما بيزودش تجده زي ما هو. لو أقل من 72 بيقلل 2 units to 4 units per day. Reduced hypoglycemia with glargine. 300 دلوقتي طبعا الجلاجين 300 وانا محتاجين لها قريب قوي و 300 ده مختلف عن الجلاجين 100 في شويه حاجات. ان rates of hypoglycemia generally lower in patients treated with glargine 300. You see? And patients not reaching this is 100 or this one 130, the rates of nocturnal hypoglycemia significantly lower in those who are taking glargine 300 more than patients who are taking glargine 100. Look at this. Glargine 300, this weight gain than with first generation glargine 100. 300 and 300 units. Novel basal insulin glargine 300 أما بنشوف ال confirming or severe nocturnal hypoglycemia لاقي nocturnal hypoglycemia patient on glargine 100 is more than patient on glargine 300. هندخل على ديجلوديك وده آخر long acting insulin وصل لنا ديجلوديك. The titration algorithm used in clinical trial denied again once simply. برضو هندي initiation in type 2 diabetes 10 units starting dose وبعدين هنرجع تاني نقول لو كان A1C أكثر من 9 هنزود في البيشنت 10 يونتس. لو كان البيشنت less than 3 and 1 A1C لا هننقص 4 وهكذا على حسب الليفل بتاع A1C. Indications of this degradation with intensified glucose monitoring and insulin dose adjusted on an individual basis, degradation can be caused in renal and hepatic impairment. Elderly patients can be used also more than 65 years old. Safety and efficacy have not been established in children. Established in children here and there. No clinical experience in pregnant women. Glargine 100 versus Degludec 100. Degludec rates of symptomatic hypoglycemia or nocturnal symptomatic hypoglycemia and type 1 and type 2 diabetes is less than Glargine, but do not mean statistical significance. That can be مهمة قوي. يعني انت واحد شغال بيه على الجلوتين ما فيش داعي تقلبه على الديجلوتيك عشان بس الديجلوتيك ده كبير ولا حاجة من دي. فنخليه ونظبطه بالجلوتين بتاعه. Basal plus third. If the patient is not well controlled with basal insulin and oral hypoglycemic agent, we can add the bolus active insulin to the main diet. So add rapid acting insulin before the meal that most consistently contributes to the largest post-prandial glucose excretion. Additional injection may be added up to 3 per day if the patient is not well controlled. But there is an increased risk of hypoglycemia if you added more short-acting insulin. Benefits of insulin. Benefits of insulin restores beta cell function, provides long-term normal glycemic control, reduces microvascular complications, may enhance patient quality of life, may reduce microvascular complications. When should glucagon-like peptide 1 receptor analogs be considered? When these drugs could be considered? When the patient requires significant A1C reduction to achieve goal? When hypoglycemia is particularly undesirable? When weight loss is an important consideration? When current therapy is failing to adequately control post-prandial blood glucose. Adding GLP-1 receptor analog mechanism of action, starting by intestinal secretion of GLP-1 receptor analog from the intestine and stomach, and the action of this analog receptor analogs are as follows. GLP-1 acts on the liver, increase the glycogen storage. On the fat cell, it increases glucose uptake and glycolysis. On the kidney, natriuresis. On the blood vessel, increases endothelium-dependent vasodilatation. On skeletal muscle, increases glucose uptake. On the pancreas, to start with, before nip the pancreas hour, increase new beta cell formation, decrease beta cell apoptosis, increased insulin biosynthesis. On the heart, increased myocardial contractility, increased heart rate, myocardial glucose uptake is increased, decreased ischemia induced myocardial damage, and on the brain, neuroprotection, increased neuroprotection, and increased memory. The currently available GLP-1 receptor analog in European Union and United States, exenatide twice daily, approved, liraglutide daily once, but there is exenatide weekly, with approved and affirmatasha, exenatide approved, affirmatasha once daily also, and liraglutide weekly approved, affirmatasha. Eulaglutide approved at 2014 and also is taken weekly. We have three taken weekly of these GLP-1 receptor analog. Here are xenotide, L-glutide and eulaglutide. GLP receptor analog head-to-head comparison, effective glycemic control, including the fourth, سنة طيب زي ما شايفين الإفكت بتاع طيب الأزرق في قلل بعد 12 ويكس الـ A1C ونفس الكلام في الإكزينا طيب بس يعني زي ما شايفين يمكن أكثر شوية لكن يولاك الوطايد ونيرا الوطايد مود إز ذا سيم ويت لوس ان جي ار تي ان ار تي كاستون ديساين ادفيرس ايفكتس ليرا الوطايد 1.2 ملي جرام is more effective, is less effective regarding the weight loss, but there is a reduction of gastrointestinal manifestation after mean 1.3. In the liraglutide 3 milligram is used as a treatment of obesity, especially obese women. في الدنيا كلها بس لسه ما وصلناش. Rationale for GLP-1 receptor analog basal insulin combination. First line, metformin. وبعدين ناخد GLP-1 receptor analog. وفي الآخر basal insulin أو معاه basal insulin. Empty simpler intensification regimen. Reduced insulin dose. Complementary control of fasting and post-prandial glucose. And weight benefit decrease body weight. Low risk of hypo. Placing here. الاثنين مع بعض وهنا الليكزيناتايد از جلوكاجون ريسبتور انالوج مع الكلارجين. الكلارجين اند البروديك هاف سيميلر بي كي اند بي دي بروفيل. الليكزيناتايد هاز ا لونجر دوريشن اوف اكشن كرانتر مان ذان الليكزيناتايد. كلينيكال ديفلوبمنت بروجرام فور انسولين ديجلوديك اند ديجلوديك Spring glargine and lexenotide but no head-to-head studies to date. Fixed ratio combination basal insulin with GLP-1 receptor analog in clinical practice suitable for the following patient. Already taking basal insulin but not at the goal. Not and offers the potential to effectively treat type 2 diabetes at an earlier age of the disease, multifactorial approach to disease management. Future use of basal insulin, liraglutide receptor analog. There are two studies, two clinical development studies of program, Viewer and Elixir, focused on patients not achieving glycemic control on insulin or insulin plus 1 to 2 or occasion. Traditional approach to intensification is to add a prandial insulin, several injections, and potential for using basal insulin, GLP-1 receptor analog fixed ratio combination as a first injection. Prandial insulin has a role, but basal insulin and GLP-1 receptor analog is an attractive alternative for most patients. And in the study needed in A1C, in Israel, in insulin degludec and liraglutide, the added in A1C after men in glargine, where in Israel body weight disease mar glargine, that's the L mar combination of insulin degludec and liraglutide. Whereas the confirmed hypoglycemia is more in glargine than in insulin degludec and liraglutide. In study 10 year clinical finding, the A1C with nisvalid insulin, glargine, and lixinatide, a change in A1C after mentally glargine washing, and the symptomatic hypoglycemia or good at the glargine after mentally lixinatide and glargine. Premixed insulin. ده اللي عندنا بقى ميكس الانسولين الناس الغلابة. Alternative up to adding a preventive concept to basal insulin. Fixed ratio combination of basal and preventive insulin in a single formulation. Usually administered 2 to 3 times per day. Inflexible, cannot change the dose of the of just one component, and this suitable for patients with regimented lifestyle, eat the same food, less حياتهم عادية وما بتغيرش يوم عن يوم, and patient who would have practical difficulties administering 2 separate insulin. Not recommended for most people needing intensification. لما نبص بقى على ال stepwise approach to management of diabetes, زي ما قلت تاني, diet and exercise, monotherapy, or combination, or patient plus insulin, completion of the insulin intensification, زي ما قلت. هذه intensification اهي. معاها rapid acting insulin, or SGLT2 inhibitor, or GLP4 inhibitor, or GLP1 receptor analog. Conclusions. Many type 2 diabetic patients are still left too long in poor glycemic control due to insulin inertia, glycemic insulin, and timely initiation and appropriate intensification of insulin therapy in primary care is essential for many uncontrolled type 2 diabetic patients. Novel basal insulin with an approved clinical profile, a reduced risk for hypoglycemia, and the greater dosing flexibility make insulin initiation in primary care simpler and safer, and may alleviate patients' concern with respect to the start of insulin therapy. Novel fixed ratio basal insulin GLP-1 receptor analog combination with greater flexibility and safety and tolerability advantages may enhance our armamentarium to intensification insulin therapy. Take home message. Insulin plays a key role in therapy for many patients with type 2 diabetes. There are several barriers to successful insulin therapy, such as clinical inertia, failure to adhere or resist with treatment. Novel basal insulin offers a significant improvement of clinical profile and reduced risk of hypoglycemia. Novel fixed ratio basal insulin and GLP-1 receptor analog combination may enhance intensification of insulin therapy, reduce the risk of hypoglycemia, and reduce the risk of increased body weight. And thank you.
على الحضره الجميله الابديتد اللي هي كلينيكال فليفر. انا هشوف افتر كومنتس. انا معجب طبعا باللياقه ونشاط الاستاذ الدكتور علي عباسي واصراره على تعليم السكر والاندوكراين عبر الاجيال, يعني من جيل لغايه الان.
عجزنا بقى.
ممتاز, لكن لسه محافظ على اللياقه. زي ما كان واضح كده الاستاذ علي وكل جايد لاينز مصرح ان الانسولين لسه علاج للتايب 2. في كان سرعه كده طلعت شويه من كام سنه كده ان الانسولين يعني مش هو العلاج الاول في التايب 2 مع دايما الادويه الجديده الاورال ومع جي بي دي 1. لكن دكتور علي كل جايد لاينز لسه حاطه الانسولين كعلاج للتايب 2 برضه. شكرا دكتور علي.